Okay, so today I'm gonna make a shorter video about how to transfer cassette tapes from a pre-recorded cassette that's sealed into a recordable cassette. Okay, so I have this album here. I have no clue what it is. It's a mystery. I know it's a chrome tape, but you see the capstan hub on, I don't know if this is side one or side two, but it's broken here, and I don't want to shove this in my new player, which there'll be a review on. New player over there. It's an Akai CSMONA. There'll be a review of that soon. I think this is, pretty sure that means Dolby, B, maybe. Okay, so the problem is, I don't want to put this in my machine. So, what I've done is I've gone and found this BASF tape. It's an LHDA 90, and before anybody goes crazy, it's the reason why I'm getting rid of it. It must have been put in some kind of bad player or eaten in the past. It's just destroyed. So, we'll get to it here. First, what we're going to do is we're going to unscrew all the screws. You want to find a cassette that could house the size of the tape, you know what I mean? I think any cassette, that's standard. But you want to find a cassette in good condition like this. I like the outer casing of this. And you're going to unscrew all the screws. So there's four corner screws. There, 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 and there. And there's a center screw right there. So we'll do all of these. And we'll continue on from there. Okay, now we have all the screws out, so we'll just open this cassette up. Stuck a little bit. It's hard doing it with one hand. There we go. Okay, and we have our reel of tape here. Okay, sadly, I can't do anything with the reel of tape since it's all crinkled up and stretched. This sounds terrible, so we'll just grab this. Grab this other reel here. We'll just toss that away in the garbage. And now we're left with this case. Okay. So we have our slip sheet here. And we have our, it's hard to see, low lighting here. And we have this metal tab here, and we have our little pressure tab, which is still in good condition. There's this metal tab here. Just in there. Magnetic strip. It's pretty cheap, actually. It's just a piece of sheet metal. And we have our two roller wheels right here. And that's pretty much it. There's a slip sheet on the other side. So what we're going to do now is, oh, okay. So I just realized that sitting up this way, it would be side two. So we need to take side two and flip it. So I will get back to you once I figured out which side is side one or two. Okay. All right. I'm just gonna say that this is side one, and if I mess that up, I could just always flip it. Take it out of the cassette and flip it. Okay, so now I'm gonna take the parts from this player and put them on this cassette because this player, yeah, this cassette tape because, well, when tapes are made, I guess, you know, they put what they need on there. So we'll just use the parts from this. Okay, so we're gonna crack this open. There's probably a million ways you could do that. I'm just gonna probably get in between the right protection tabs and crack the case. So I'll be back once I crack this tape open. Yeah, I actually turned the light on here so you can get a little bit of a better look here. See, this is definitely a chrome tape from its dark black appearance. The centerpiece right here, just came right out. That's kind of the center part of it here. I'm not going to reuse the rollers or anything like that. We're just going to take this tape here and spool it out of this tape. Probably backwards, though. Hopefully, that'll be the right way. And then we're going to transplant this stuff into there. So, I'll be right back. Okay, scratch the idea of using a different pressure pad and magnetic metal bar. Can't think of the name right now. Yeah, this type of setup is very particular, and it doesn't come out easily, and it doesn't fit, so we're just going to use the original stuff. It shouldn't make that much of a difference. We have it loaded up here, so that's side one. That's the the left is the take-up reel, and the right is the supply reel. There we go. And well, we're just going to screw this back together, make sure we don't pinch anything, and yeah, I'll talk to you when it's done. Okay, now, some of you will probably be saying, well, that doesn't make any sense. If you take a type 1 tape, with no notches on it, then how are you going to play a chrome tape in a type 1 cassette? Well, that might have deterred me in the past, but this CSM01A player actually has a tape selector switch, so it doesn't really matter what markings there are, unless you want to play it on something else, of course, and, well, then you're out of luck, but I am going to take this and figure out if it's the right side, and if it's not, I'll have to flip it, and then I'll give you a little, maybe a demonstration, okay? And also,
a word for the wise,
whatever, I like to mark what it is. Even though I have the switches and I could figure it out. Like, I know it's Dolby, probably Dolby B or HX Pro. I'm not sure. It's probably B. I know it's Chrome, so I'll mark all that stuff on there so that when I go to load the cassette, I know what I'm doing. And I will also mark the album name and maybe the track names if I have enough space.
Okay.
So, let's see how it works. Well, this became a long video. It's going to be upwards of 8 minutes. But, it was backwards, so I had to kick myself and flip it around. So now side one to side one, side two to side two. It is Bon Jovi, New Jersey, thanks to Siri. And I just have my crude markings there, CRO2, Chrome, and the Dolby, very bad Dolby symbol. There's side two. So just gonna pop it in for a few seconds here on the new player. And dust head. No copyright infringement on that. That was just demonstration for anyone watching this video of actually a short demonstration of how the player plays, but more than that, just the fact that the tape has been safely transplanted into this BASF 90-minute shell. So that's it. Also, you want to make sure that both of the Right Protect tabs have been gouged out, because you know, on this machine especially, play and record are really close, you know, so be recording over a nice album. So that's it. Thanks for watching, and there'll be more videos coming soon. Thank you.